So today I'm on my new set that I'm trying to work on because I kind of feel like going and filming downstairs because I don't feel like carrying my tripod and the camera up and down again, and it's kind of tiring. Let's start. And also, before anything else, I would like to greet you guys a happy new year and also a belated Merry Christmas for the ones that I haven't greeted last Christmas because I never really posted any personal video. I'm now here to start answering all your questions which you guys sent me for 2 months. How late is that? So anyway, first question is from Ian Rodilia. Where do you usually get your ideas in making your videos, and who inspired you a YouTuber? I mostly get my ideas from a lot of fashion gurus like Michelle Van, Drew Scott, Luca Fersco, and Karen O as well. So I do watch a lot of fashion gurus in YouTube. Time to time, I also watch most of my co-Filipino YouTubers here in the YouTube sphere. I do get a lot of my inspiration from other YouTubers, articles in BuzzFeed, anything that is viral, I get a lot of inspiration from that. I turn it into something that's workable in my own channel here in YouTube. Inspired me to be a YouTuber. When I started filming myself in YouTube, I think the YouTuber who inspired me was Jax Gap and also Bunny Mayer of Graveyard Girl. The next one is from Kate. You see yourself settling down someday with someone and a little kawaii kid of your own, like what NVH is. I'm not really sure what NVH is or who NVH is. Of course, I do see myself settling down with someone, but unfortunately, something happened. You guys know that. So, but if ever another guy comes along, or the perfect person, or the perfect man comes along, then most likely I would think about settling down, but not in a hurry. I need to know him first, and yeah, get to know him first, like, before I think of all that settling down. Next question is, and yeah, I do want a kawaii kid. I would actually want a little boy, and then I'm gonna dress up my little kawaii kid and be like the perfect dad. Next question is from Benjamin, and hi, what are your favorite kawaii shops? Hello Benjamin, so my favorite kawaii shops would most likely be JapanLoverMe.com, Unif, Dollskill. They're not really kawaii, they're really more of a European store, and they're really popular from the Japanese subculture, so I can even consider it as a kawaii shop, so yeah. The next one is from Bae. Oh my god, sorry. Oh my god, it just hurts me. The next one is from Bae. Who or what is your spirit animal and why? My spirit animal would be a hamster or a rabbit, because maybe I got like a rabbit teeth and I see myself as a bunny, and I don't know, they're really cute. If I were to have a spirit animal in my second life, it would be a rabbit or a hamster, but I would actually prefer rabbits because they're bigger compared to a hamster, because hamster cannot really live that long compared to a rabbit or a bunny. Next question is from Teresa. Violet, blue, or yellow? Hello Teresa. So my favorite color from this three would be blue. I do like purple, but purple's not here. Periwinkle's not here. But according to these three options, I would only choose blue. Next question is from Thomas. Hi Tommy Tom. How do you read the letters in the keyboard starting from Q to M and vice versa? Gordon Bills, just for fun. Alright, let me just get a keyboard. So I got a keyboard. It's Q W E R K Y U I O P. A S E F G H J K L Z X C D E N M. That's it. You are so random. Wait. Another question is from Jasmine. Ano pong camera ginagamit nyo, and I love the quality. In English, what kind of camera are you using to film your vlog? When I do this kind of video, I use a Canon 600D. It's really mediocre. It's really good for beginners if you want to start a YouTube channel. you can prefer using Canon 600D because it has a flip screen and you don't really need a touch screen. And then when I do my vlogs, like when I go outside, I use a Lumix, a Panasonic Lumix. If you want to know more about what camera I use or if you want to see more details about it, check out my room tour from last year, which is 2015. I filmed that one last year and I did feature two of my camera there. Made a quick mini video of how it looks like and what my favorite camera when I vlog. So I will leave you guys with a link below or maybe watch this video here. Let me know if you've seen it and let me know what you think about the camera and also my view. The next question is from Jeff. What video editing software do you usually use in editing your YouTube videos? Hey, Anonymous Singer 11. So the video editing software that I use to edit my videos is Final Cut Pro X. And then when I do animations, I use iMotion, or I think we call it Motion. I don't really use Adobe Premiere or Sony Vegas Pro, but there's only two softwares that I know how to use. It's either Final Cut Pro or Sony Vegas. And I also know how to use iMovie. I started editing my videos before from my first channel, which is already removed in YouTube because I don't want you guys to see it. Been using iMovie. Then I transfer and create it into Final Cut Pro in my editing because I feel like you can do more when you use Final Cut Pro and you can do less if you just want to cut, paste, and put music and put transitions or anything. Not really all the advanced stuff. You can use iMovie instead of Final Cut Pro. But if you want to be an advanced video editor, I suggest you guys to use Final Cut Pro X. And then when you want to color your videos, you can use CineStyle and install it on your camera. And then when I color my videos, I use Magic Bullet. That's how I do my thing. That is why all my videos are so colorful, because I do all the post-processing in Final Cut Pro using Magic Bullet with the use of CineStyle. Next question is from Pancho. Hello, Pancho. So the question is, name your top three fashion icons and how they have inspired you in the work that you do. So my three fashion icon would be Jean Paul Gaultier. Next one would be, God, what was his name? Vivian Westwood, of course. And then the third one would be John Galliano. I really like them because they're really eccentric whenever they think of their designs. And also their runways are really something special. If I were to choose top four person that I would choose would be Alexander McQueen, because Alexander McQueen should be in my list as well. Place him on top one and then just remove Jean Paul Gaultier. Alexander is already dead. We have to pay tribute, so let's place him on one. I also like Jeremy Scott, but there's like a lot of fashion designers that I really like and take inspiration from. The next question is from Helen. Hello, Helen. Hello, the beauty blogger, the not your normal. Helen Bayal is not your normal beauty blogger, so you can check her channel out. She's really good and she's really funny to watch whenever she does her makeup. So do check it out and subscribe to her. So her question, what is your favorite clothing brand? My favorite clothing brands, oh my god. It's Uniqlo, H&M, Terra Nova, oh my god, Acne. If we have Acne Studios here in the Philippines, I would actually import a lot of stuff from Acne. What are my favorite clothing brands? Zara is also nice and top man, but I don't really like how they price everything here in the Philippines when it comes to Zara and also Comme. I would actually choose Bershka over those two, because Bershka is really like an affordable version of those two. Next one is the last question. Woo! I'm able to finish from top to the last. So the last question is from Neil. Hello, Neil. So thank you for sending me this question. You actually sent me two questions, but the other one was kind of like the same one with Helen. So I already answered your question for that. And then this question was really interesting that I really have included in a video. Neil's question is, will you ever have a meetup? Yes, I will be having a meetup soon, sometime in the first or second week of January. I will be having a meetup together with two fashion YouTubers. So, and then one YouTuber as well, who is a guy. So there's two girls and one guy. He is gonna be premiering his YouTube channel soon, and I'm really excited to do it because I'll be buying a lot of food bags and a lot of giveaways for you guys who will be attending. I will be seeing you there. I will be posting more details about the meetup soon. And that is it, you guys, for my Ask J Daily. And it's the first, no, it's the second one for this year. And I will most likely have another two for the year of 2016. Hopefully by 2016, I will be having a lot of Ask J Daily. So I'd be able to talk to you guys. You guys get to know me more. And thank you guys for watching. I do hope that your 2016 will be more fun, more enjoyable, more kawaii, and more exciting, because we will be having a lot of great stuff to look forward to this 2016. And do subscribe on my channel, that's youtube.com/JRDaily. And follow me on my social media accounts. I always update and I do my vlogs, vlogs and Snapchat, and I tweet a lot in Twitter. And do follow me on Facebook if you want more updates, and also Instagram if you want to see more of my mini micro photography vlogging. Thank you guys for watching, and I will see you on the next year. And yay, happy new year. Thank you guys for watching, and I do hope that you enjoyed this last Ask J Daily and the last content for the year of 2015. I will see you on next year, and I will be going to Baguio. If you guys are in Baguio, do hit me up, and I will see you there on January 24 with other Filipino YouTubers as well. So do say hi if you see me in the street, and I will see you. Bye. Love you. Happy New Year. Bye.